Some breaking news from Washington tonight. NBC News has learned that President Obama will extend health care and other benefits to the same-sex partners of federal employees tomorrow. The move would come after weeks of criticism from gay rights advocates about the administration's lack of action to repeal the military's Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy and for his Justice Department's inflammatory defense last week of the Defense of Marriage Act. This past Friday, that was. These details on the new executive order are scant, but it appears that the president will give partners of federal employees access to health care and financial benefits like relocation fees for moves. These are the types of benefits that married partners of opposite sex couples who are federal employees already enjoy. This is not a benefit that will be extended to gay and lesbian couples in the United States broadly, but just those who work for the federal government. The announcement is expected in the Oval Office tomorrow. For more on this breaking story, I'm joined now on the phone by our chief White House correspondent, Chuck Todd. Chuck, thanks very much for joining us. What details do we have about this announcement tomorrow?
Well, as you pointed out, not a lot of details. I mean, this sort of frankly got stuck into the daily guidance, and we got no heads up that this was coming beyond that. And when you talk to White House officials, you're getting very little details. Simply, this is a memorandum that he's going to be signing it. I don't think we should quite call it an executive order. I'm getting mixed signals from folks inside the White House of whether it's an executive order or a memorandum, and the difference may be whether this would extend beyond when the president would leave office or just take place while he is in office and head of the federal government. So that's a detail that I still would like to get my hands on, and I'm still waiting for from them, and that's something we'll find out tomorrow. But this does have the feel, frankly, of just how you set it up. I mean, you can't look at it, I think, through any other prism other than faced with what has been a lot of criticism of this administration that they have not followed through on some promises that he made regarding Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and then what they did with the Defense of Marriage Act. I think they felt as if they needed to do something for the gay community because they were starting to feel some pressure. There was some I think a fundraiser that Vice President Biden's going to be going to, where a prominent fundraiser asked to have their name pulled because they were upset about the lack of attention that they felt this administration was coming. I mean, there were some folks that I talked to that thought this was going to happen early, like one of the first days of the administration, that he would extend this right to federal employees.
Chuck, to be clear on the memorandum versus executive order issue, you're saying that if it's an executive order, it would effectively become the law of the land until another executive order or something contradicted that. But if it's a memorandum, this change would only be enforced during the term that Obama was in office.
I think so, but don't hold me to it. That's okay. Why I want to. But there is a difference between memorandum, like, because they're calling this a memorandum, not an executive order. Hmm. And so that means there is a legal difference. I believe that's the difference, but I apologize for, you would think that my job is to know that immediately offhand, but you know what? We are full of transparency here at MSNBC and NBC, and I'm going to tell you, I don't have that is a clarification that I'm trying to get, which is simply, is this going to be just for the president's term, or is this something that it would take another order to overturn for it to roll back?
Chuck, one last quick question. As I understand, the Defense of Marriage Act, which has been the source of some of the controversy last week with the Thursday night brief filed by the Justice Department that used some real inflammatory language to defend that law, so far as I understand it, that law specifically blocks benefits like these from going to same-sex spouses of federal employees. It's not just about not recognizing a same-sex marriage at the federal level or in a state in which that marriage was not sanctified by the legislature.
Right.
They specifically block these benefits. Do you have any insight into whether or not this is treading on DOMA territory?
Well, and what it could very well be, and this is, I don't want to get into speculation, but the counsel's office may have realized, this may have triggered why the president had to sign this thing and decide to do this, because they were worried that that's exactly what it was going to do. That was actually going to roll back rights that were already there in some places, and they're trying to avoid that issue and maybe tamp down some of the controversy that was surrounding how many viewed the Justice Department's brief.
Chuck Todd, NBC's chief White House correspondent. Thanks for your reporting tonight, Chuck. Looking forward to figuring out more about this complicated situation.
And I will promise lots of questions to Mr. Gibbs tomorrow at a minimum on this issue on motivations, because motivations, I think, are always very telling on a lot of these issues.
All right. Thanks, Chuck. Look forward to it.